We're looking at one of the most important works by Caravaggio, the Supper at Emmaus, painted between 1605 and 1606. It is a large painting, it's horizontal, and the figures are almost life-size, which gives the painting a real sense of proximity and intimacy, drawing the viewer into the scene. It's a haunting Baroque masterpiece, painted during a dark period in Caravaggio's life when he was exiled after committing an act of manslaughter. The story is that Jesus Christ has been crucified. Two of Jesus' disciples are walking along a road to Emmaus, and a third man joins them and they decide to have dinner. This third man breaks the bread and at that moment reveals himself as the resurrected Christ to the amazement of the disciples. What we're seeing is that reaction of the disciples, the moment they recognize Christ, that split second in time of high drama. You can see the disciple on the right leaning forward and clutching the table in disbelief, his face expressing fear and excitement at the same time, while the disciple on the left raises his hand in shock and amazement. All eyes are on Christ. As a matter of fact, the two disciples frame our vision as we move closer to the painting, to the center, to Christ's somber face and gesturing hand in the sacred act of blessing and breaking bread. The painting is dramatic. You can see the contrast between the intensely dark background and Caravaggio's ability to play with light, which draws our eyes to exactly what he wants us to see. Look at the light, almost a theatrical light, on the left side of Christ's face, and how the face and body of the disciple on the right seems to be spotlighted. Another typical characteristic of Caravaggio's paintings is his use of ordinary people in ordinary settings. We're at an inn. Jesus is accompanied by two disciples, the innkeeper and the helper. And perfectly represented here is the moment the divine enters everyday life, reaffirming and strengthening our faith in Christ. In Supper at Emmaus, Caravaggio portrays life as he lived it, a flawed humanity, vulnerable to poverty and suffering, and expresses his desire for salvation offered by faith in Christ.
所以这个过程呢，就是说你用接手还是要加胶，可是胶的东西呢，这个acrylic本身塑胶很重，粘不上颜料，所以最后上面是一层是接手，因为接手比较粉的，比较抛的，可以着色这样子。如果次数越多，等于接手你用的越厚，你一定要记得要加胶，就是这样。要不然会裂。胶的比例一开始的话，底层的话，我就说一半一半，一半的胶，一半的接手，然后慢慢的胶减少，接手增加，所以这样acrylic 很接手的比例就是这样，递减。这个roughly就可以了。滚这个东西啊，不能快，滚了以后呢，尤其是第一次滚，一定要给它 complete dry。 你做完以后呢，如果很 rough， 你可以用 sandpaper 来掀过，用 sander 将它磨过，磨了平再来滚。这个是胶纸，这个
sandpaper， 那哪一个号数的用 medium 就可以了，因为滚筒滚的过程还是有 texture。那你如果要真的要一张完全像镜面那么平的画布，那你就是要做很多层来渗，来磨平它这样子。我想卡罗瓦角完全。
传统最传统的油画，他们用兔皮胶，然后他们还兔皮胶的目的就是来先 seal 这些 canvas 的缝，然后再用 不同的颜料，都是矿物的颜料来弄。每一个人的画法不一样，那你如果买 already on structured canvas， 你就不必有这个过程。可是我喜欢把这个 canvas 钉在板上面，那钉了也要把它钉 smooth。那我用板，所以有这个easel，我用这个电的easel，然后我用 projector 来go outline。为什么要钉在板上呢？因为你一张画一直，不管你是用铅笔用 whatever brush 都要给它压力，日子久了会松。那有一个传闻就是说 Caravaggio 其实也有他的 device， 在虽然在17世纪他有那么多的人物，听说他有一个设计可以用 project 来也是做这个 outline， 这个 要有考证就是了。
咁我根據一個西方油畫好耐嘅傳統，就係以一個光同暗嘅分隔而去捕捉一個物體嘅個立體性。因為始終我哋係一個三度空間嘅世界裏面，但係油畫個畫面係一個兩度空間。喺呢個情況下，一個好好嘅方法就係以一個光同暗去幫我哋捕捉呢個立體。因為一個立體佢唔同嘅面會有唔同嘅反射光嘅程度，而得出個唔同嘅色調同光暗。咁首先我就要揾盞好強嘅燈咧。另外就係色温就比較重要嘅。通常習慣上啲人就揾個比較中性一啲嘅色温，例如5500K 嘅色温。跟住就係一個控制你光源嘅問題啦。咁好多時候任何空間佢都有各式各樣嘅不直接嘅光嘅。就算我有盞燈去照住一個蘋果，但係蘋果後面埲牆都會反光嘅，甚至個畫家本身佢件衫都會反光。所以有好多你好難去完全控制到光就一邊嚟咁。一個比較常用的就是找個譬如一個紙盒啊，各式各樣的覆蓋物去隔開一些你不想要的光。Caravaggio 他喜歡畫人的，那 他描寫一些很戲劇性的東西，即是等於 你去看一個話劇啊，一個舞台劇啊，佢都係好興係有一個好強嘅光照住一個講嘢嘅人啊，唱歌嘅人啊，咁所以 Caravaggio 佢嗰種畫風就同嗰種戲劇式嘅打燈方法係有一定嘅相似嘅地方。有很多西方油畫，佢個影嘅黑暗的地方是比較暖啲嘅。你看翻 Caravaggio， 佢畫人嗰陣時候，你睇下佢光同暗嗰個分界線，其實有少少顏色的變化嘅，所以唔係除了光同暗之外，個顏色嗰個變化都可以幫助你去捕捉一種立體。